Good morning to you all present over here. Last time we discussed the chapter Living World. Today we will discuss next chapter, that is Biological Classification. Now, in this chapter, we will discuss two kingdom classification, three kingdom classification, four kingdom classification, five kingdom classification, and a six kingdom system of classification. And then we'll go inside what are the organisms that comes under that system classification. Okay. So first of all, we have to discuss two kingdom system of classification. Now, this two kingdom system of classification, this was given by Linnaeus. The scientist's name was Linnaeus. So it was given by Linnaeus. Okay, many times asked question that who proposed two kingdom system of classification. So that is proposed by Linnaeus. Okay. Now, initially, or we can say traditionally, all the organisms belongs to only two kingdom. One was plant and one was animal. So what we can say, traditionally organisms classified into two kingdoms. That is Plantae and Animalia. So initially or traditionally, organisms classified into two kingdoms. One is Animalia, one is Plantae. So Plantae means that has fixed position, and Animalia means that can move from one place to another place. So what was the major criterion for classification of this kingdom? So the major criterion of this classification what was the criteria that belongs to this? So first was presence or absence of cell wall. So first is presence or absence of cell wall. This is the important one, presence or absence of cell wall. Okay. Another criteria was what? Already discussed, movement. So another is locomotion. Okay. So first, presence or absence of cell wall. Next, locomotion. Okay. Then next was what? Mode of nutrition. Third is mode of nutrition. Okay. So, and another was what? Response to external stimuli. Response to external stimuli. Okay. Etc. But basic one was what? Presence or absence of cell wall. Okay. Then another criterion was locomotion, another was mode of nutrition, another was response to external stimuli. Okay. But this kingdom system classification that was used for a long time having some shortcomings, some drawbacks were there. What was that? that we have to discuss. So shortcomings of two kingdom system classification. Okay, shortcomings of two kingdom system of classification. Now, first was what? This kingdom system classification does not distinguish between unicellular versus multicellular. So what was that? This system of classification did not distinguish between unicellular versus multicellular. Organisms. Now, what was other drawbacks? So other drawbacks or shortcomings was what? Also did not distinguish between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes means nucleus proper having, and eukaryotes means, prokaryotes means nuclear absence or incipient nucleus, and eukaryotes means true nucleus. So this system did not distinguish between prokaryotes. Prokaryotes means not well developed nucleus. Okay, versus eukaryotes. Well developed nucleus. Okay, so did not distinguish between prokaryotes versus eukaryotes. Okay, then another one, what? They also don't distinguish between photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic organisms. So did not distinguish between photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic organisms. Okay, so this was the major issue, shortcomings or drawbacks in this system classification. Now, some organisms were there like Chlamydomonas, Euglena, slime molds, that was taken, okay, that was taken characteristic features by geologists as well as botanists. So that also provide shortcomings. Some organisms such as Chlamydomonas Euglena slime molds etc. that claimed by both botanist and geologists. Okay, so these were the some shortcomings or drawbacks of two kingdom system classification. Okay, now since these problems creates okay within the time period, okay, so scientists were thinking for having problem or having creativity that is creates confusion. So that confusion will be given to a new kingdom. Understood? So plenty, no problem will come on plenty. Organisms that contains features of plant, so that will come plenty. Organisms containing feature of animalia comes under this group. But those having some problem, means botanist or zoologist both claiming that one, that organisms, so that is coming under third one. Okay, so in this way three kingdom system classification was identified. Okay, so now come on next, three kingdom system classification. Now here one thing is that in three kingdom system classification, it is also known as a dustbin kingdom. Three kingdom system of classification. Now, this is also known as dust bean kingdom. Why it is known as dust bean? Already discussed. Those not comes under plant, those not comes under animalia, means confusion creates. So that will comes under three kingdom system classification. Okay. Now this three kingdom system classification was proposed by, so this was proposed by scientist name is Ernst Haeckel. Okay, so Ernst Haeckel gave three kingdom system classification. Okay, and named it Protista. And named it Protista. Okay. So three kingdom system here, what was that? Three kingdom. Now previously it was animalia and plenty were there. Now recently introduced by Ernst Haeckel, that was Protista. Okay, so all the claimed, that is claiming by both biologist, means geologist, as well as botanist, comes under here, and that is not having any confusion. So characteristics coming under animal, animalia, characteristics come under plants, so come under planty. Okay, now this includes wide variety of unicellular as well as multicellular. Okay, so these containing what? Unicellular, this contains organisms characterized as or categorized as unicellular and multicellular. Okay, so here what happens, unicellular as well as multicellular, they are what happens, distinguished easily. Okay, now in protista mostly comes under where? Unicellular organisms. Okay, so in this kingdom or in protista, unicellular organisms are kept and remain this multicellular goes ahead. Okay, so in protista what comes, unicellular organisms are kept. Mostly what was the unicellular? Aquatic organisms mostly unicellular comes under where? Kingdom protista. Okay, so here three kingdom system, what was that? One is plantae, one is animalia, and one is protista. Okay, now come on next one, four kingdom system classification. Four kingdom system classification. Now come on that. Four kingdom system of classification. We already seen what was that? Plantae, animalia, protista. Okay, now here once this another groups came, that is known as a monera. What is that? Monera. Okay, now this system classification given by Copeland. So this system of classification was given by Copeland. Okay, so this system classification, or we can say four kingdom system classification, was given by which scientist? Copeland. Okay, and he gave this kingdom name Mycota. You have to remember that, and named it Mycota. This term you have to remember. This is the medical question, that Mycota term given by, or Mycota as a fourth kingdom system classification given by. So that was given by Copeland. Now Mycota replaced with Kingdom Monera by Dufferty and Allen. This scientist name you have to remember, Dufferty and Allen. Sometime question asking, term Monera was coined by. So term Monera was coined by which scientist? Dufferty and Allen. Okay, now here what are the organisms are coming? Here prokaryotes are coming, eukaryotes are coming. Now in eukaryotes, like cyanobacteria are coming, okay, blue green algae are coming, then archaebacteria are coming. So this contains mostly prokaryote or prokaryotic bacteria and eukaryotic bacteria. Okay, like cyanobacteria, or this is also known as blue green algae. Okay, so mostly Monera belongs to which group? That are containing bacterial groups. What we can say, that containing what? Bacterial group. Like actinomycetes also. Actinomycetes means filamentous bacteria. This also contains actinomycetes group. This is known as what? Filamentous bacteria. Okay, so this four here, one thing you have to remember, kingdom Monera term given by Dufferty and Allen, and who gave four kingdom system of classification? So that was given by what? Which scientist? That is given by Copeland. Okay. Now come on, next, that is known as five kingdom system classification. That is most accepted classification system till yet. Okay. So come on, next, five kingdom system classification. Now, this five kingdom system of classification, this was given by R. H. Whittaker, okay, in 1969. So, this system of classification was given by, who given? This system of classification was given by R. H. Whittaker. Okay. And that was given by 1969. Okay. Now, this is most used and accepted kingdom system of classification. Okay, now it introduced a new kingdom fungi. Okay, fungi. So previously what was that? Five kingdom means previously what was that? First we see Plantae, then what we see? Animalia, then what came? Protista, then what introduced? Monera, then what introduced last? That is kingdom fungi. Okay. So this fungi or fungi, so this belongs to what? Five kingdom system of classification. Okay. Now, this five kingdom system classification, which is most accepted in the scientific world, that having some criterion, okay, that having some basis on which this classified. So what was that? So first was what? Complexity of cell structure. We will discuss this one in elaboration. Okay. So first, what was that? Complexity of cell structure. Okay. Under complexity of cell structure, that comes under what? Prokaryotic versus eukaryotic organization of cells. So prokaryotes versus eukaryotes. So one criteria was complexity of cell structure. Then complexity of body organization. Complexity of body organization. Now here what was that? Unicellular versus multicellular. Okay, unicellular and multicellular. Then what was that? Mode of nutrition. And mode of nutrition means autotrophic and heterotrophic. So come on, that mode of nutrition autotrophic, those who are making their food by own, and heterotrophic, depends on others, heterotrophic. Okay, so this is mode of nutrition. Okay, then another one was what? Reproduction. Then another one was phylogenetic or evolutionary relationship. Okay, so phylogenetic organisms. Okay, now here questions already asked in JIPMER that which is the most important criteria for the classification of five kingdom system of classification. So most important is mode of nutrition. This you have to remember. This mode of nutrition means autotrophic versus heterotrophic. In heterotrophic many was there, like holozoic is there, saprophytic is there, okay, parasitic is there, that we'll discuss later. So come on, that characteristics of these five kingdom, what are that we have to discuss now. So characteristics of five kingdom system classification. So what are the characteristics for distinguishing these five kingdom? So first we'll discuss characters. So one column is characters. Okay, one column is characters and remaining are kingdom. So we have to see, first we will discuss Monera, then it is Protista. Okay, Monera, Protista, then fungi, and remaining two are Plantae and Animalia. So Plantae and Animalia. So these five now come on characters. First character is cell type. Okay, so first is, what are the cell type they are having? Now in Monera belongs to prokaryotes, so it is prokaryotic means they don't have well developed nucleus, and the remaining four are eukaryotic. Now here questions are asking, on the basis of cell type in five kingdom system classification, which are containing only prokaryotes? So that is what? Kingdom Monera. Okay, now second, what was that? That is a cell wall. Okay, so second characteristic was cell wall. Now in Monera they are non-cellular. Okay, they are what? Non-cellular, and they contain which type of cell wall? They containing polysaccharide and amino acid. So it is non-cellular cell wall, and they are having what? Polysaccharide plus amino acid. So this is containing what? Non-cellular cell wall. Okay. Now in protista, someone contains cell wall, someone not contains. So what we can say? Present in some. Some organism. Okay. So in protista, what is that? Present in some organism. Okay. Now come on. Fungi. So fungi having what? They are containing present cell wall, but this cell wall don't have cellulose. So present cell wall, but without cellulose. Without cellulose. Okay. Now fungi having what? Without cellulose. Now come on planty. So planty contains cell wall, present cell wall, and they are having what? With cellulose. With cellulose. Okay. Generally, this fungi containing what? Chitin. Cellulose is the cell wall is there. So that is having what? Chitinous. Chitin. Okay. Now, in animalia, absent. Absent cell wall. So animalia don't contain cell wall. Now, next we have to see nuclear membrane present or not. So next is nuclear membrane. Since prokaryotes only having what? Kingdom Monera. So nuclear membrane only absent in Kingdom Monera. So what we can say? Kingdom Monera, nuclear membrane absent and remaining are present. Presence of nuclear membrane. Present. Present. Okay. Now, next characters are body organization. Which type of body they are having? So, body organization. Okay. Next is body organization. Now, if we are coming on Monera. So, Monera having what? Cellular type. So come on that, Kingdom Monera, cellular, okay. Protista, this is also belongs to cellular type, okay. Monera and Protista both having what? Cellular type. If we are coming fungi, so it is a multicellular. These are unicellular, this is multicellular. And multicellular, they are containing loose tissue. Okay. So multicellular they are having and having what? Loose tissue. If we are discussing about planty, so they are having tissue level, oblique organ level. Okay. So body organization in planty is what? Tissue, oblique organ. If we are seeing in animalia, so they are having tissue, organ, and organ system. Means they are more complex organ system in animalia. Okay. Now, next we have to come on the last characters, that is mode of nutrition, that is more important. Okay. Most important basis. So mode of न्यूट्रिशन। ओके ना, इन मोनेरा दे आर हैविंग ऑटोट्रॉफिक एज वेल एज हेटरोट्रॉफिक। सो कम ऑन दैट, ऑटो ट्रॉफिक। नाउ ऑटोट्रॉफिक मीन्स दे आर मेकिंग देयर फूड बाय ओन, बट मोस्टली इन ऑटोट्रॉफिक दे आर हैविंग व्हाट, दे आर मेकिंग बाय केमिकल्स। फ्रॉम वेयर दे आर मेकिंग फूड, केमिकल्स, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज कीमोसिंथेटिक। कीमोसिंथेटिक दे आर मेकिंग फ्रॉम केमिकल्स, दे आर फूड फ्रॉम केमिकल्स, सो कीमोसिंथेटिक। ओके, एंड सम वन ऑल्सो हैविंग फोटोसिंथेटिक, सो कीमोसिंथेटिक एंड फोटोसिंथेटिक। ओके, एंड अनदर इज